What's going on, everybody? Josh, starter raingutterbusiness.com. Just wanted to go over our trailer setup today. Kind of walk through how we set our trailers up, size of them, the options that we get, where you put the machine in here, and everything that goes into setting the trailer up. So I've been in the gutter business now for 15 years, and we've had a few different trailer and van options. And this is what we've ended up with as our ideal trailer size and type. This is one of our newer ones, probably 2 years old. It's a 7x14 Mirage trailer, and you can get these for like $5,500 brand new. You really don't save much getting them used if you're going to use it a lot, so I suggest getting a new one. And this is just standard height with barn doors in the rear. That way you can walk right up to the back of the trailer and work. If you get the ramp door, it makes it a little tougher. You're always kind of hunched over doing stuff right around the front of the gutter machine. So Mirage also makes these ladder racks. They just bolt onto the frame, and we put those on there, and I put anything bigger than a 24-foot ladder on top of the trailer. So those work pretty good. It's just a bumper pull, double axle, or these are springed axles. You can get a little more expensive one with torsion axles, and I've had those, and they seem a little more bouncy to me. So this particular machine is an Ironman 5/6-inch combo machine. It's a little bigger than your standard 5-inch machine, so it does fit a little bit wider in here. These KW machines are rock solid. We've had a few of them, and I've had a few different brands, and these are my favorite by far. So we buy them as a package. You can get them as like a complete package, and they come with these stands that hold the gutter machine up off the floor. They come with the coil cradle. We just get the mini coil cradle, and then it comes with gutter runout stands and then the guillotine on the front. So kind of comes with everything you need. Seems to me like that's the best way to buy everything and kind of gets you set up, and so you're not hunting down parts to find stuff to make everything work. So since this is a bumper pull trailer, you really want, and these machines are fairly heavy, this is like 1,400-pound machine, you want to be mindful of your machine placement in the trailer. So I have this a little bit offset to this side, gives me a little bit more room to walk down this aisle and to put my ladder that I use the most, and I work from this side of the machine the most. And then that gives me a little bit less room to put my downspouts and stuff in, but that's all right. As far as mounting goes, this particular setup, I built a little frame, bolted these stands onto my frame, and then bolted the frame through the support beams in the trailer just to make sure that it wasn't moving around and that held up over time over bumpy roads. So kind of the layout in here, downspout boxes on the left, they fill this aisle. I mean, I can fit probably six or seven boxes over here if I need to. Coils and elbow boxes I usually put in the rear from that side door, and that gets those coils onto my mini coil cradle easy. And then on the left here, I try to keep it as open as I can to walk through here, grab my ladder, keep my stands on there. These come out right first thing at the job, so those are out of there. And then under the machine, a lot of times we keep couple extra boxes of end caps of, you know, white usually, corners. We have some T-straps for the Raytech hangers, and just any other random stock stuff that you want to keep in your trailer. Next, I want to talk about the ladders that I keep in here. I keep one 8-foot fiberglass ladder up on racks on the wall on the right side of the trailer. On the driver's side of the trailer, I always keep a 24-footer in there. It's a lot easier to get down than keeping it up on top of the trailer, and then it keeps it out of the weather so the ropes and stuff doesn't fray quite as quickly. Just goes right above the downspouts on a rack up there. And then we also use these Ladder Max ladder stabilizers, and I usually just hook those right on the extension ladder. So up front here, the most easily accessible stuff is the stuff that I use the most. So we have a case of glue that I always keep right up front. You use that a lot, as well as hangers, and those I usually just pull out of there and set right next to the trailer at the job site, so they're right next to me and I can throw them in the gutter. And then I keep a toolbox up here close. All the kind of random tools that I don't like to carry around in my tool bag all the time, I just keep in here, like extra bits, speed square, there's a hammer in there, a couple sheet metal bending tools, stuff like that. And a little bit further up the passenger side aisle, I have keep most of my screws that you can easily access through this side door. And stock your tool bags with them. So I keep some 2-inch rubber washer screws that are ceramic coated, and then 1.5-inch zinc plated screws for standard like construction style install. The other thing we keep a lot of is zip screws. So these are a bunch of different color zip screws. I've tried it a couple different ways. I've used these bags for quite a while. And they're a cheap way to do it. They don't quite, you know, going down bumpy roads and stuff, they do tend to mix up and you can't quite see the screws as much. So I've kind of transitioned to these Makita Packout boxes, which are awesome. I love them. They're a little more expensive, but they're sealed. They keep all the screws in the same bins. And I just keep the 5 main colors that I normally use in each trailer. And then I actually have a separate bin for the more random colors that we use. So these seem to work really good, and then they lock on to your toolbox if you're using Makita toolboxes or Milwaukee toolboxes. Another thing I've experimented with is this glue tray here. These glue tubes tend to leak when the sun hits them or they're just sitting there for a little while. So I just made this little gutter glue tray, and it catches all the chips from out of the machine, so it kind of saves you on a little mess there. And then I just throw my caulk gun in there after getting done with each gutter, and it saves you some mess. And then if this thing gets beat up or full of caulk, you can just screw it out of the floor and throw a new one in, and there's plenty of gutter scraps around. So at the one of the doors at our shop, I have these trailer supply lists and tool checklists put up, because we keep forgetting stuff out on the road. So it's nice to have just a little mental reminder of what exactly needs to be in each trailer, and then all of your supplies that you need for each job. So this has been helpful just to make sure that each trailer is set up with the right stuff and you get to the job and you're ready to go. Thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you guys enjoyed our trailer setup video. Make sure if you have any questions or comments, put them in the comment section below, and we'll get right back to you. And make sure if you like these videos, subscribe, and we'll bring you a bunch more content. Thanks for watching.